We are looking at Revelation chapter 12. Amen. It's an extension of what we began on Sunday night during the State of the Nation, you know, address and the intersection, which we hope by the grace of God will continue every Sunday night on Zoom by 9 p.m. to 9:45 thereabouts. Amen. Just a 45-minute Zoom meeting that is put together from the Global Christian Update to be able to communicate the burden of the Lord to the church. We'll just briefly look more into what we began looking at that day. Praise the Lord. Revelation chapter 12. I will read from verse 1. Amen. It says, "And there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, amen, and the moon under her feet, and upon her feet a crown of 12 stars." This is a great woman. Hallelujah. Amen. "And she, being with child, cried." What did she do? Child, what did she do? She cried, "travailing in birth, and pained to be delivered." Amen. Verse 3. "And there appeared another wonder in heaven. And behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns upon his head." Amen. How many heads does the dragon have? Having how many? 7 heads. So and out in each there is a crown in this each of the head. Amen. He has horns, and he has how many horns? 10 horns. Amen. Then verse 4 of Revelation 12, he said, "And his tail did what? Drew the third part of the stars of heaven." Amen. "And did cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman, which was ready to be delivered, for to devour her child as soon as it was born." Verse 5. Verse 5, he says, "And she brought forth," what did she bring forth? Read with me now. "She brought forth" what? "A man child," not a child. She brought forth, you're not following your Bible. What does your Bible say? "She brought forth a man child who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up unto God and to his throne. And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she had a place prepared of her," amen, "of God, that they should feed her there 1,260 days. Praise the Lord. "And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angel fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought and his angels." Praise the Lord. And the Bible says, "And prevailed not, neither was their place found anymore in heaven." Amen. Praise the Lord. You read further, you know what happened there. But let's go to our emphasis today. And on Sunday night during the Zoom meeting, I did explain that the woman who was described from verse 1 is actually talking about the church. And when you read it by revelation, you know that it's actually the church. Because the church is going to be taken away for how many years? For what? For how many days? The Bible says it's going to cut off. For that is about 3.5 years. Amen. The woman will be to be cut off away from whom? Amen. What did he say? From the dragon. Amen. "And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she had a place prepared of God." And Jesus, remember what Jesus Christ said now? Jesus said something in John chapter 14. He said, "I go to my Father, I go to what? I go to prepare a place for you." So this is what the Bible is talking about here. He said a place was what? Was prepared of who? For her, of God. So this has a correlation with what? With John 14 from verse 1 to 6, where Jesus says, believe in God and believe also in me. He said, in this world you have tribulation. But be of good cheer. He said, believe in God and believe in me also. He said, if I go to my Father, I go to prepare a place for you. And when I go, I pay a place for you, I'll do what? I will come again to take you. So at the rapture is when this woman, who is going to be taken? When this woman is going to be taken to a place. And she's going to be there in a place prepared for her. Hallelujah. Why is she going to be taken to that place? Because of who? Because of the dragon. And who is the dragon? The dragon is who? Is the one that will come to make rage at the time of what? Of the rage of the Antichrist. So when you begin to see some of these things, you now discover that the people who are the proponent of what? Of other rapture position, they are not actually correct. Because the woman must be taken away from where? She must be taken away from the dragon to a place prepared for her. For how many years? For 3.5 years. She's going to be cut off. So it means that the dragon will not be allowed to prevail over the woman. Hallelujah. The dragon will not be allowed to prevail. The woman has to be cut off. And that describes the world. It describes the rapture. What the Bible says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 from verse 13. Amen. Say, I will not have you so like those who are without hope. Amen. For within the twinkling of an eye, the trump of God will sound. And what shall happen? And the dead in Christ shall what? They shall rise first. And those of our life and remain, we shall be caught up to meet him in the air. And Luke chapter 17, from verse 34, made us understand. Amen. That on that day, what shall happen? He said what? He said, for two shall be walking. One shall happen. One shall be taken, one shall be left. Two women shall be in the grounding. Amen. And then what shall happen to them? One woman shall be taken, one shall be left. Talking about the day that what? That the woman. So what is going to, because the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5, where he talked about Jesus coming for a glorious church, a church without wrinkle, a church without spot. So what shall happen? The woman will definitely going to be cut off. And we established during the Zoom meeting, though I didn't go this dimension of the rapture on the Zoom meeting, but I'm going in dimension today, in this teaching meeting today. Praise the Lord. So the woman is who? Is the church. Who is the woman? The woman represents the church of Jesus. So, the church of Jesus, something is going to happen. The church is going to be cut off. Amen. To where? To a wilderness. But we understand that this, he said, and the woman fled. Are you there? And fled into the wilderness. Amen. Where she had a place prepared of God. That they should what? They should feed her there what? 1,203 days. So the woman will be there, will be fed. And we are made to understand from Matthew 25 that actually what will be happening there is called the supper of the Lamb. And that is what also Revelation 19 also portrays. That what shall happen? He said, come, let us rejoice, for the marriage supper of the Lamb have come. He said, and what? He said, and her bride have make herself ready. Amen. Praise the Lord. And what happened to her? Let's go to that place, Matthew chapter 19. Let's see Matthew 19. Let's see what the Bible says in Matthew 19 about this same event. Because the things of God, they are not ambiguous. It is we that we are making it to look ambiguous. They are so simple as God has made them. Are we there with me? Revelation now. Which verse are we now? We are in chapter 19 of Revelation. Let's go back to Revelation chapter 19. No, Revelation 19. I made a mistake. Revelation 19. Amen. When you read Revelation 19, it says, and after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, hallelujah, salvation and what? And glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God. Verse 2, it says, for true and righteous are his judgment. For he had what? He had judged the great woe. Are you hearing that, man? He said, which did corrupt the earth with her fornication. And had what? And avenged the blood of his servant at her hand. Amen. Verse 3 says, and again they said, hallelujah. And her smoke rose up forever and ever. Amen. Let's go down. Let's go to verse 7. Amen. Verse 7 says, he said, let us what? Let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to him. For the marriage of the Lamb is what? Is come. And what happened? His wife had made herself ready. Verse 8. He said, and to her was what? Was granted that she should be what? She should be arrayed in fine linen, clean and white. For the fine linen is what? Is the righteousness of the saints. Verse 9. He said, and he said unto me, write, blessed are they, which what? Which are called unto the marriage supper of the Lamb. Amen. And he said unto me, these are what? The true sayings of the Lord. Verse 10. He said, and I fell at his feet, amen, to worship him. And he said unto me, see that thou do it not. I am the fellow servant and of thy brethren, amen, that have the testimony of Jesus. Worship God, for the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of what? The spirit of prophecy. Hallelujah. So there's going to be a cutoff. Amen. There's going to be what? The cutoff. So the woman is going to be what? Is going to be hidden for how many days? Amen. For 1,000 plus, that is when you put together, it's God, it's actually 3 months, 3 years and a half. The woman will be hidden. Amen. Praise the Lord. What happened? The woman will be what? The woman will be hidden. Amen. Which verse were we in? The Revelation chapter 12? We're in the place, the Revelation chapter 12. He says, okay, verse 4. He says, and he still drew the third part of the stars of heaven, and did cast them into the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman, which was ready to be delivered. For to what? For to devour her child. Hallelujah. And then, okay, we're in verse 6. Verse 6 says, and the woman fled into where? Into the wilderness, where she had a place prepared for her. Amen. That she should be what? Be fed there. How long? For 1,200 and what? And 60 days. Amen. That is about 60 days. 1,260 days, which is actually 3 years and a half. Verse 7. He said, and there was war in heaven. Michael and his angel fought against the dragon. Amen. And the dragon fought and his angels, and he prevailed not. Praise the Lord. So you discover what we are looking at today is that the woman is the church. Amen. And the church will definitely have to what? Has to be cut off from the face of the dragon. Amen. She has, that is God's arrangement. That the dragon will not what? Will not succeed. That the dragon will not what? The dragon will not succeed. Amen. So there is a provision for the woman. So the dragon word will be cut off. Amen. For 3.5 years. Hallelujah. From where? From the face of the dragon. Amen. So what does it mean? It means that there is going to be an intervention for the church. And that is why Revelation chapter 3 verse 10 says what? He says, and I will keep you from what? From the hour of temptation that will come upon the whole world. Let's see that in Revelation chapter 3. Revelation 3. Are we there? Revelation 3. Jade, you can read for us. Revelation 3 verse 10. He said, I will do what? I will keep you from where? From the hour of temptation that shall what? That shall come upon the whole earth. So there is going to be an hour of temptation that shall what? That shall come upon the whole earth. And who is the tempter? The devil. The devil is the tempter. So there is going to be a worldwide hour of what? Of hour of temptation. And who is going to be the tempter? The devil is the tempter. The Bible says the tempter is who? Is the devil. Matthew chapter 4. So, and Jesus has promised the word. He said, and I will keep you from who? From the hour of temptation. Praise the Lord. Just like what the Bible says here. We said, who is the woman? The woman is a church. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And we have seen that the woman who fled to where? To the wilderness, where a place was prepared for her. Of who? Of God. And Jesus told us, I'm going to prepare a place for you. And when I go, I will come and take you to the place. That's what I, where I am. There you will be. So why the devil is here raging? Amen. Tempting the whole world. Forcing humanity to what? To receive the mark.
happen to the believers in Jesus, they will be what? They will be cut up to be with him in the air. They will be cut off. The believers are going to go. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. So we continue this teaching in the part 2 of the series. God bless you as you tune in Jesus' name.